Trump humiliates Obama with Thanksgiving proclamation, does the one thing Barack never would. President Donald Trump has released his very first Thanksgiving proclamation as POTUS, in keeping with tradition. In the process, he has humiliated his predecessor by doing the one thing which Barack Obama never would. The original purpose of the Thanksgiving holiday was to give thanks to God for all our blessings, according to the American Presidency Project. However, most Americans are unaware that Thanksgiving as a federal holiday was rooted in war, namely, the Civil War's bloodiest battle. Especially poignant was President Franklin D. Roosevelt's last Thanksgiving proclamation, which was issued on November 1, 1944. With World War II drawing to a victorious close, FDR wrote, "In this year of liberation, which has seen so many millions freed from tyrannical rule, it is fitting that we give thanks with special fervor to our Heavenly Father for the mercies we have received individually and as a nation and for the blessings He has restored, through the victories of our arms and those of our allies, to His children in other lands." Near the end of his proclamation, after impressing upon Americans to give a united thanks to God, Roosevelt recommends a nationwide reading of the Holy Scriptures during the period from Thanksgiving Day to Christmas. Today, we cannot fathom a president's Thanksgiving proclamation recommending a nationwide reading of the Holy Scriptures for 3 weeks. Such an assertion by the president would undoubtedly result in an impending crisis over the separation of church and state. In light of this, it warrants taking a look at just how far has our nation has drifted from the Judeo-Christian values it was founded on. For example, President Barack Obama's final Thanksgiving proclamation in 2016 did not mention the name God or Almighty in the text even once. Instead, Obama lauded tolerance and inclusiveness as the end-all to be-all, writing, "As we gather in the company of our friends, families, and communities, just as the Pilgrims and the Wampanoag did centuries ago, let us strive to lift up others, promote tolerance and inclusiveness, and give thanks for the joy and love that surround all of us." Fortunately, though, it is now 2017 and God is back in the White House. In fact, President Donald Trump's Thanksgiving proclamation invokes the name of God 5 times. On Thanksgiving Day, as we have for nearly 4 centuries, Americans give thanks to Almighty God for our abundant blessings, Trump's proclamation begins. "We gather with the people we love to show gratitude for our freedom, for our friends and families, and for the prosperous nation we call home." Trump even quotes from Lincoln's 1863 proclamation, stating, "As President Lincoln recognized, no human counsel hath devised nor hath any mortal hand worked out these great things. They are the gracious gifts of the Most High God, who, while dealing with us in anger for our sins, hath nevertheless remembered mercy." The president closes his proclamation by encouraging Americans to do what Obama would not. "I encourage all Americans together, in homes and places of worship, to offer a prayer of thanks to God for our many blessings," writes Trump. "As we celebrate Thanksgiving this year with our families gathered around, we would all do well to take pause and reflect on the reason we are celebrating in the first place. And, as we thank God for our many blessings, we ought to count our faithful president, Donald J. Trump, among them."